It looks like we're all set up and ready to go. I just need to tell people that we've gone live. For some reason my laptop's frozen. That's not good. There we go. No, it's back. Right, let's let the peoples know that we're back. I was put live now, but it sounds like I'm saying commanding people to live now. Like some kind of fucking necromancer who's paid by the word. Let me just make sure I'm putting the right thing in. So in case you missed previous streams, last week's stream, we are space adventurer Malia McDonald in the Outer Worlds, and we are currently in Emerald Vale. We're trying to decide. So we've got a ship that we can't fly yet because we need a power converter or some kind of electrical dealy bob. There's two of those on the planet. One of them is in the hands of Edgewater, which is a creepy ultra-capitalist hell town. Where people are... Stop walking in front of me, dude. Where people are kind of worked to the point of exhaustion, fed, stuff that isn't food, and just generally having a shitty time. The other power thingy is in a bunch of people who deserted Edgewater, and it's... and we basically got to decide who gets the power compared to, like, each other. They've both got good points. I need to figure out the controls still. It's not that button. So this is the geothermal power plant that we need to... There we go. Oh, we need to fast travel right there. Let's get right into it. We're currently accompanied by Pavati, who is an engineer from Edgewater, who is really fucking good in a fight, like it turns out. But she's really useful. And she's helping us out, getting us acclimatized to the place. And, I mean, it's all on the YouTube thing. I can't really summarize everything that happened, because we got, in addition to all this, we got, like, rescued from a... Right, hold on. We find the controls to... That's crouch, that's... let's zoom in. R2 is to fire, that's to jump. These are my weapons. I think square was the reload, yep. Okay, so let's go get that power. Dealy Bob. But first things first... I bought a specific thing to help with... Here we go, that's what we wanted. But we need to unequip that. I will get used to the controls eventually. That's how you say it. Okay. Okay, used to it. So let's unequip this and actually equip this, because as we know, the things that are in the power plant are robots, and they are weak against electricity, as one of the side quests helpfully explained to us last week. So we can find a way in. That looks super dangerous. I don't think we want to go through there. Go. Get right back into it. Oh. I do like this gun. The electricity stuff. That's the... Oh, shit. It's been a week since I've played it, so I'm not... I'm still kind of, still, like, And to be fair, it took us like about an hour to get used to the controls last week. So yeah, pretty much jumping right into it.
I've always wanted to poke around in here.
You get your wish today, Pavarti. I'll take you to all the nicest places. Dervish mist. Now let's take all this, fuck it. Pocket watch is good, little vendor trash. Ooh, we can hack this as well. So we're like, oh, we can disarm security fences. View recent logs. Yeah, that's kind of an error message, looks like. Nothing new there. I hope everyone had a good week in this horrible hell world that we live on right now. With our various shitty governments and horrible capitalism and random violence and AI, and let's hope none of those issues attack us here in the Outer Worlds. For those who know the game, those are the only issues that happen in the Outer Worlds.
Ooh. Incoming.
This is a fucking beautiful gun for robots. So I think I'm not doing too badly. One thing we do got, it's gonna make the screen real fucky by now. One thing we do have to do is we have to make regular saves because I don't trust the autosave and there's no quick save option. So my only criticism for like the UI of this game. Other than that, like aside from it being first person, there's a few things about this game that aren't ideal for me. Because first person makes me all claustrophobic and have trouble orienting myself. Which doesn't help me navigate the world. There's also the quicksave issue. But kind of other than those two things, like, it's actually fairly friendly to people with colour blindness, which is one thing I really appreciate about this game. Like, it's the colours are really distinctive, and the I think I might have colourblind mode on at the moment, actually. I can't remember if I
The control room should be off to the right.
Cool, let's use the vending machine, though, because what have we got for sale? Do you have any ammunition? What about healing stuff? Overtake. Well, they're expensive. We can't afford as many of those as I would like. We don't actually have a lot of money, to be fair. Hopefully we'll pick some up. Let's buy two of those. We don't use a great deal of healing stuff, but it's good to have a lot of it. Can we sell? We can sell stuff too. Great. Let's see what we can sell. A couple of flywheels and a pocket watch. So not quite enough to excuse me. No. There's choice. Yeah, those jingles are gonna get stuck in everybody's heads, especially mine. Ooh, what's that? Ambidextrine. Ooh. Yeah. Oh shit, we've got a combat drone right there too.
Everyone all right?
I think we've so if I remember correctly, we're specced towards non-violent solutions to problems, so we're good at like science and let's to get back to Emerald Vale. We're smart and charming, basically. Then we chose our background, the bureaucrat background. So I think that helps us a little bit with our non-violent problem-solving abilities. Oh, what's all this? I need to borrow your copy of the Young Spacer's Guide to Mechanical Engineering. Radio's been sputtering, I need the reference. I've returned the copy to the repair bay. So that's where the third one of those is. That's good to know. We basically did a lot of side quests last week. Chaos everywhere, mechanicals gone haywire, gunfire, hearing some screams. Oh lord, I think that was someone's leg. Would like to leave early for the day. Please deduct delinquency fee from my pay. Thank you. I'm proud to be a member of the Spacer's Choice family. Yeah, so everyone is like super capitalist in this world. Like, people aren't allowed to leave their jobs, they've got to work all the time. So I joke that, like, it's Britain in, like, 10 years, but it's close to Britain now. Which is a very grim fucking prospect, I think you'll agree. Yeah, I've not been paying attention to the... Because I moved from Twitter to Blue Sky recently. So I don't use Twitter very much. I'm still on Twitter. Like, I've not, like, deleted the account. So it's good to kind of have... just to keep an eye on things. In case they get new owners soon. I seem to remember this area being bigger than this. Should we explore a bit before we... Wait, is this... Because that feels like that's the thing that we need to decide who gets the power. For some reason I remember this... Oh, I see there's some stuff down here too. Wait, I wonder... You know, it's not gonna force us into a decision right away. Let's take a look at it. Plan status. Let's not redirect the power, because that seems like... Let's explore the area first. Maybe there's some stuff here we can use. What was I saying? Yeah, I've not been on Twitter very much, but there is some stuff apparently going down. Like, some really important news is happening. So I don't have the chief's keycard to do that. I have not been paying attention, so I may say something completely fucking... out of maybe fascism has come completely in the time that since I last checked Twitter, so I wouldn't put it past this fucking stupid country. What's this? Unlock the personal files. Oh, that's a lot of things. I found a fiddle in one of the mechanicals, so I had to write them up for tampering with the company property, just in case I'm reading this a couple of days from now and feeling bad for what I've done. Let me just remind myself that I've warned him before. He's always been a little crooked in the skull. Doesn't sit right with me. Company's been replacing our guards with auto-mechanicals. At this rate, I'm going to end up a chief of security with no staff. There's a small army of mechanicals knocking about, guns pointed every which way. Company tells us they're safe, programmed to treat us humans like their own. People are liable to break down, but an auto-mechanical never will. Doesn't sit right with me. Companies. Company's never been wrong before, I suppose. Fuck. It's a lot of faith. what's happened? Mechanicals gone crazy. Locked myself down here, just trying to gather my courage. Gonna make a mad dash for the control room. We'll delete this if I ever return. Automated message. Shit. Unlock the door. Huh. I thought that was a door we were unlocking. Oh well. Again, quick save, just to, you can't see it, but I created a save file outside of the geothermal plant, too. So just in case things go horribly wrong. Let's have a look at these, because we got a quest called Die Robot and the Frightened Engineer. So is that the logic unit has been locked in a storage room across the hall. You need to find the key card from that room that you can pick your way in. So find the security chief, get his card, and that'll get... And this is... There might be a volume of Young Spacer's Guide to Mechanical in the Plant's Repair Bay. So there we go. That's kind of logged in now. We're not the best at stealth. I don't know why I keep sneaking up on things. So I kept crawling and it kept working. Very conscious about our ammo situation as well. I'm not really replenishing what we're using. Oh, there's a robot there. I love this gun. Actually, what ammo does this use? Is this, oh, I'm looking at the wrong thing. Oh, it's heavy. Okay. So we need heavy ammunition. Excuse me. My voice is gone. Oh. Don't know what I just did, but I did something. You can be sure of that. You're not a robot. You're a wall. Right, control. Oh, shit. So you're getting all these weapon modifications, but I don't... Well, it doesn't say I don't use them. I just feel like I need to find a weapon that I really like that I want to keep for the rest of the game before I start modding it, putting mods on it and stuff. Okay. Pristine items can be identified by a diamond near their condition markers. It's fucking grim. This is what happens when you trust AI, folks. You start to, it will eventually kill you. Because there are people who are, like, starting to be like, oh, I think we should start worshipping the AI as a god now. You know, nutcases. Who are like, is this alive? Oh, Jeremy, you're a friend, aren't you?
Self-diagnostics complete. Navigation systems operational. Combat systems operational.
Pavati fixed you.
It's the spacer's choice.
Why aren't you attacking me? Well, you made it out of that junkyard. Why aren't you attacking me?
Actions towards spacer's choice mechanics are contrary to logical directive. Conclusion. All hostile auto-mechanicals must be defective in compliance with Spacer's Choice policy. All defective auto-mechanicals must be permanently dismantled. Please allow me to assist.
So you would help me destroy those mechanicals?
Mechanicide protocols loaded.
Mechanicide?
Confirmation.
Ish. Confirmation granted. I like the sound of that. You gonna help me? Cool. I say like, oh shit. Young Spaces guy, I think it's volume 3. I need to read something down. Did something to read down in the pit. Wait, does that tell me that it's, according to the notes, there's a copy of the manual down in a place called the pit. Okay. Corporate sent a team of technicians to conduct a complete refit of all of our mechanicals, every sentry and drone. It's not my place to say so, but doesn't this run contrary to the Spacer's Choice mission of being as cheap as possible? Just in case I'm ordered, I would like to formally express how grateful I am to be part of the Spacer's Choice family. Spacer's Choice is the leading brand in affordable sundry across Halcyon. It's not the best choice, it's Spacer's Choice. I like even the slogan rips them. Just finished a routine maintenance on our mechanical sentries. I found some strange modifications to the logic modules. I haven't had time to run a diagnostic, so I don't know what's been modified. All I know is that I should be watching the stream on my laptop and not on Blue Sky is what I should be doing, because it's going to go off any minute. There we go. Everything's fine. Nothing is ruined. I filed a report. My supervisor told me not to worry about it, said the company knew what it was doing, ordered me to forget about any alleged modifications to the logic modules, decided to do a bit of sleuthing by my own self, got my hands on a logic module, time to do a little experimentation. So they changed the logic module on their robots, and that made them go nuts. Okay, let's see what's up here. Exploring around, really, and there's nothing pointing me in this direction, but kind of worth a look. I can't quite use my hacking skills. I'm not good enough at hacking to get in there. This is where we were before. Okay, so we kind of explored that area. Jeremy went through.
You're not real.
Yeah, there are people who like say we worship the AI as gods and let them make the decisions for us and stuff now, like some real creeps and stuff. And I think, aside from the batshit insanity of that entire premise, they're robots. They're going to do the most logical thing possible, which is to say, it's not logical for a human being to have the any more than the recommended calories per day. So you'd have like, and it's also, it's not logical to bother with flavor, for example, or texture. So it'd just be, if the AI made the decision, it would just be like, okay, you have your flavorless nutrient paste that has just enough to sustain you for the day, no less, no more, no less. And like, we obviously you'd need water as well. So how do you get, after a certain point the water's going to run out, or it's not the optimal decision to, I'm going somewhere with this, don't worry, I'm getting distracted by that dude screaming all the time. It's not optimal for like someone to have more water than they need, and urine is perfectly fine. So we'll end up in a situation where the AI will logically be like, you know, you have just enough energy to sustain working, to sustain your work with no breaks. You'll be drinking your own piss after a certain point. Yeah, like, and people thought this through at all? Ooh, impact hammer. Anyway, that's my 2 cents about that. Hey, creepo.
You're not real. You're not real. Get away from
that
me,
motherfucker
back.
Right there. This is not real. not quite. Calm down. I'm not trying to hurt you.
Talk? The phantoms never talked before. Oh, I knew I shouldn't have eaten that sprat raw. See, Higgins? This is why you must always boil your sprats before ingesting.
Boiled sprat. You're not imagining me. Slow down and tell me what's going on. Wait, you're eating sprats?
Of course. Sprats are an excellent source for my daily recommended intake.
Yeah, mercury, that's famously not poisonous.
I use it as a reminder.
Cool. How long have you been down here?
Hard to say. By my reckoning, Higgins has been here somewhere between 2 weeks and forever. My recollection's a touch fuzzy these days.
Referring to himself in third person? Surely that's a good sign of perfectly functioning sanity. What do you do here?
Higgins has been many things over the years. Sprat Wrangler, Saltuna Critic, Aetherwave Personality, Chairman of the Board, Galactic Defender, Sisty Pig Tycoon.
Some of those, they made up.
I've come a long way for someone who started off as a simple engineer right here in this plant.
How have you been surviving all this time?
Jimmy opened the vending machines. That lasted a good couple of months. Eventually, I had to resort to more unconventional means of filling my insides.
Looks like it's been abandoned for a while. What happened?
Mechanicals lost their bolts. Opened fire on anything that moved. It was pandemonium.
And you weren't killed?
I was on cleaning duty at the time. My old boss had me scrubbing pipes when the killing started. So, as usual, I missed out.
Probably lucky, then. You mentioned being an engineer.
I specialized in automechanicals, drones, sentries. Repaired them, maintained, upgraded. Did it all from my old workroom, just over in the next section.
If you worked on these mechanicals, you must know a way to stop them.
Look, I don't want to fall into any trouble with the mechanicals. If they wise up to our plans, they will come for us. With prodding irons.
That sounds it's my least favourite thing to be prodded with. I can deal with the mechanical limit this far, or you can help me. And I won't feed you to the sprats. That's a bit mean. I can help you deal with the mechanicals. I made it this far.
You know, you remind me of myself back when I was an intergalactic adventurer.
Yeah.
I discovered a flaw. Their hostility levels were hardwired to maximum. There's no changing that, but you could rewrite their targeting protocol so they attack each other instead.
Oh, yeah. Mechanicals follow the behavior of the logic module. Someone tampered with it.
Yes, that's exactly it. I see you're also versed in the noble art of mechanical engineering. There's a behavior control terminal in the other room. It should have options to change how the mechanicals act, including whom they shoot at. Oh, that reminds me. You'll need my passcode to access the behavior control terminal. Here, let me just write it down for you.
Any idea where I can find a logic module?
Funny thing. I was working on a logic module just before the mayhem started. Security chief found me and confiscated the logic module.
I'm gonna ask you something.
Definitely start with the tail. If you're feeling adventurous, the ears are a particular delicacy.
What actually happened to this place?
Lost their
I know this. It's horrible.
You mean why did the mechanicals go on a murderous rampage? Same reason any of us do, I suppose. The voices didn't do it. I was on cleaning duty at the time.
I know that. This reminds me of that, like, security guard, that robot security guard they had that after a day on shift tried to drown itself. It's like the prospect of working under capitalism just made it just want to self-terminate. Says it all. Anyway, let's have your copy of the engineering book and your ammo and your ointment. Let's reset our thing to do die robot. So we're going to find a logic module now. Okay. But then we've got our old pal Jeremy just fucking going to town on all of his old robot buddies. So he's probably done a lot of the fighting for us. It's a very good thing that we, the Pavati repaired him, I guess. And I talk shit about AI, but I'm like still like, oh, Jeremy, our old buddy. I'm humanizing the fucking thing. So what we need is the security chief's corpse to get their key, use their key to, open the door and get the logic module.
Okay, go on quiet.
Oh, they were here the whole time. I think we did everything. Modify behavior. Set new mode. We can't do, but we can set the new. Define intruders. Define intruders, spaces choice, auto mechanicals. There we go. Hey, I just noticed the autosave kick in there, so I was just thinking I need to save. Anyway, let's head back. Time, weapon parts. Leaving all the weapons, because to be honest, they're not really that useful. Trying to think. So we've reprogrammed all the mechanicals now, so we can. They'll kill each other. We're pretty much safe to run around at our leisure. Let's talk to Higgins again. See if he's got any news for us after we've done that. Yeah, my voice is going. That's not a good sign. Wonder if we can convince him to leave.
What's I mean, you?
We could convince him with a fucking gun to his head. I'm going to ask you it's something. Him. Actually, hang on.
Forgot what you were going to say.
Okay. There's no change there, then. Is there any other stuff? So, return to Ludwig to get that. So, we were trying to get the... I can't help but feel like we're missing something here. Like, there's something we're meant to have done that we just haven't seen. I keep going to use the use button is the same weapon, the thing that draws your gun. So I keep going to click on an object and then just whipping my gun out instead. I don't think we've explored this section yet. How do I pick that? Ooh, was that a box? No. Oh, one shot.
Mind the steam. You're liable to get scalded.
Good advice. Thank you. Because I genuinely wasn't thinking about the steam. I was just going to run right through it. Engineering shut off the steam. Hey, we can use our engineering skills. Yeah, I said weapons are not terribly, unless they're better than what we've got, they're not terribly useful, because they just take up space, really. And you're only really going to use them to break down anyway. Ooh, what's this? I'm just flicking switches, I don't know what they do. Oh shit, didn't even see you there. Yeah, this gun is a dream for the robots. Like, just does so much damage, and it's got such a good fire rate. Oh, we're missing something here. Oh, this is something new. I mean, I guess this is something that we kind of... Like, we missed, because we didn't divert the power right away, but I think maybe we were supposed to do all three of those before we could divert where the power went. It's probably a good thing that we wandered around first. I'm lost, I don't know where I am now. That is... okay. This is the way we came in. Alright, there's the, so I am kind of going off on, multiple tangents here. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to go for the third way. Like, we're trying to find a compromise between, Edgewater and...
If you do this, there's no going back.
Where are you?
Yeah, huh?
Did you have, like, something? No, nothing. You're not going to offer me any wisdom or advice on...
Excuse me, man.
Oh, here we go.
Look, I know you want your power regulator and all, but I just got to ask you. Do you understand what you're about to do?
Nope, I've been pulling switches and not knowing. I wouldn't mind hearing your opinion.
I don't think you should cut off Edgewater's power. I think it would be cruel. I'm sorry. That just sort of came out all at once. Edgewater's hurting. We've been losing workers year after year, and corporate hardly ever sends replacements. There's barely enough Saltuna to fill our bellies anymore. But the town's got some good people in it. Decent, hard-working folk just living their lives the only way they know how. They don't deserve to be punished.
The deserters are a community. I can't just destroy what they built. Reed tells me Edgewater's going to die without workers in power. I see your point. I'm ready to make a decision. Let's talk about that.
Miss McDevitt's built something beautiful. Somehow she's talked the ground into giving life again. It's plain to see she's made the Vale a better place. Fed the hungry, tended the sick. Gave a home to those that had none. But Miss McDevitt delights in Edgewater suffering.
It's true, she does.
She wants to hurt the town. Do you really want to be party to that kind of hatred?
See a point, I'm ready to make a decision.
Sorry, I didn't mean to grab it like that.
No, I advice. I'm glad you did. I like hearing from you. Yeah, like...
Really? wow. Thanks. No one's ever told me...
She knows more about this than I do, so it's good to get her input. Just want to... double check them, so I know that that is the aim button, because there's a, is it R1, is that the, yeah, I was wondering what the button was for that. Anyway, let's make another save here before we make our decision. So kind of no matter what we do, I was always going to save Edgewater. So let's redirect the power. Continue. Redirect power to Edgewater. May God have mercy on our souls. There we go. That's... So we need to get the power regulator from somewhere. And now we need to do something. So even though we destroyed their deserter town, I believe there is a way to bring them into Edgewater and deal with the plague at the same time. Because, oh yeah, there's a plague happening in Edgewater as well. Yeah, because all the people in Edgewater are on their knees. If we took their power away, innocent people are going to suffer. The innocent people are going to suffer either way, but... it's kind of the needs of the many type situation. Before we... set that to there. And fast travel to their home near hostiles. Okay, where are the hostiles then? Oh, what is the hostile? Oh, they're back here. Okay, let's deal with those then before we move on. I didn't know there was a way you could get back here. Oh, no, nobody!
That's the last of them.
Don't know why I was worried about her. She's really good in a fight. Is this anything? I always feel bad sending my companions on ahead because, I always kind of assume, with them being computer-controlled, they're not as good as I am. But the companions in this are quite sturdy. They can handle themselves. Fast travel is that button. So we'll talk to all the people in the camp here. So maybe there's... So I think we can kind of convince them to push the head of the town out. Or at least get an option to shoot the guy in the head so they can take over. Because I only know because I rediverted... Because everyone does the... rediverts the power to this camp their first playthrough, I think. I did that. And you get a bad ending for this whole area. Like, it ends up with, spoilers, but... all the people from Edgewater who would have been fine, or would have, not fine, but, like, had lived there, were begging to come to this community, and she's like, no, you can't come in. Sorry, guys. I know you're probably mad at me. Where's...
I know. I'm trying to think.
Where's your... Take me to your leader.
Adelaide's okay.
Oh, there you are.
Everybody keeps staring at me. It's not my fault the power's dead.
Today's your lucky day. No, got a data pad.
Really? Well, which one?
The elusive part 3. Someone stashed it away inside the old geothermal plant.
The geothermal plant? Now that is just incredible. You really went exploring down there? Adelaide always told us it was swarming with hostile mechanicals.
Oh, it was.
That's a complete set. All three parts. I'm gonna be the greatest engineer Halcyon's ever seen.
I like this guy. It's a shame we doomed him to starvation and death.
I swear, do you proud.
I'm glad we could help, Thomas.
I've been saving something for you. Just a little contraption. Should fit right into your outfit.
I should go. Hey! We can level up. I can't remember what we put points in. I feel like we could do... I feel like we're gonna need all the persuasion we can get. So let's... Should I put everything in there? Or should I do some medical tech stuff too? Or should I do some stealth stuff? So I feel we're okay for, like, damage and stuff. Split the difference and do 2 in melee damage and 3 in stealth. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Home is where the heart is. Marauders took that saying a little too literally.
Where's Adelaide? She's not going to be happy.
That's the thing about growing old. Your eyes start to fail. Elsewise, I would have seen you for the snake that you are. Chopped you into pieces and roasted you on a spit.
I get that you're mad.
Doing. Cutting off my power. Killing off my garden. Without refrigeration, my food will spoil, and my flock will starve. I want to ask you this in private, away from the eyes of my flock, so they do not see me lose my temper. Tell me, why did you do it?
Reed needs his people back. This isn't personal. I need your power regulator. I don't want to mention Reed, because that's going to send a ballistic. Shit, let's go with that's the best option.
You killed my garden, destroyed my community, sentenced my flock to a lifetime of slavery.
Doesn't have to be this way?
For a power regulator. Well, shit, I wish it was personal.
Look.
Go talk to Grace and Thomas. Look them in the eye and tell them their life here is over, and the only thing left to do is go back to Edgewater. This is now your responsibility.
Maybe there's something in the third way.
You tell Reed Thompson that I will never return to Edgewater. I would rather die among my flowers than live under his
mind. Third way? I'm willing to deal with Reed for... Oh my god! This is like... You're being unreasonable, come back to Edgewater. Feels like it's pushing a... Oh, I'm willing to deal with Reed for you? That feels like the option to get rid of him. This is how this thing is written. I may end up saying something I don't actually mean here. That could mean two things there. I'm willing to deal with Reed for you.
You offering to cross Reed off, huh? This some sort of twisted
motivation
for what you've done? Or are you just looking for a chance to sow some chaos? Kill Reed if you must. Or talk him into leaving if you can. He and I are not sharing the same four walls together.
I need some help convincing him.
Tell Reed that I can make his people healthy again. I can end their plague. Start a new garden right in the cannery.
This is the third way.
Square meals for every man and woman.
I think we've done it.
Tell him how I've made the veil bloom again. The soil has whispered its secrets to me, and I alone know how to breathe life back into the earth. The secret is human corpses. I've been grinding them up in my fertilizer for years. Marauder, worker, don't matter much to me. The human body is rich with nutrients.
That's, what happens when you run out of corpses? I don't know why I'm pushing it.
Water cemetery's got corpses aplenty. Enough for a generation's worth of crops.
You know what? That sounds grim, but... Well, they're sitting in the ground anyway, and if it was my dead body, I would rather that be used to feed the living. So, enough talk. Right, we can convince those. Or we can go deal with Reed. I'm going to make a save here, because I feel like our... options are, like, our words are going to be real important. That was, like, I wasn't sure about that. Like, when it said, I'll deal with Reed for you, I thought it meant, like, oh, I'll talk Reed into letting you return. And it's, like, I thought that would... Both options there seemed like it would make it go fucking ballistic. So I wasn't sure which one to go with, but I'm glad I picked the right one. And just the way that was phrased, I was, like, shit. Both of them could be the bad option. Yeah, if you get rid of Reed, if we can talk him into leaving, that'd be great. If we can't, we may have to shoot him in the head. I am prepared to do either one. Crouching is useful. To improve your accuracy, make you a small target. Health doesn't help you watch toss-ball matches, though. Let's change our equipped weapons, because I don't need this. This is good for robots, but that's a better gun for dealing with people. And we are going to have to deal with some people, I think, before the day is done. Where are you, Reed? Got so many... so many things, it's kind of hard to... those are those, and always up there, okay.
I've been feeling pretty low.
You'll find your job. Oh, he's got bodyguards. This is going to make things tricky. Let's make a save here, because this could turn to shooting.
This is a fine day, friend. Power flows through our town like a cool stream of water. I trust Adelaide's people have seen their way to reason. So, when can I expect them back at their posts?
Cold fucking bastard. I spoke to Adelaide. She won't come back so long as you're here.
Then we are at an impasse. Stewardship over this town has been entrusted to me by Spacer's choice. I am not perfect. I have made my share of mistakes. But I have done my best for this
town. The thing is, he believes that. Change of leadership. The town's terrified of the plague. Abernathy asked me to steal some... You let Adelaide's son die. A change of leadership may be what this town needs.
I'm a Spacer's Choice man. My father was a Spacer's Choice man. Edgewater may not look like much to some buttoned-up freelancer, but it is my home.
Even with the plague? Adelaide's people aren't getting sick with the plague.
I don't believe you. Plague's a reality of
life. Best treatment is a good work, I think.
A good work, I
think. the town doesn't eat anything but salt tuna. Have you people ever eaten an actual vegetable?
The very notion is just grotesque. A raw vegetable? Why don't you just ask me to go chew the bark off of a tree?
Like...
We are a Spacer's Choice Saltuna cannery. We eat salt tuna here, and only...
But you said yourself you were putting weird shit in there. I'm pretty sure it was your food made you need Adelaide's garden. What exactly are you putting in those hands? That's it. I know you fill your cans with anything you can salvage. It's not healthy. Ooh.
Health is a state of mind, friend. Afflictions in one's body are reflections of afflictions in one's work ethic and attitude. Now listen, I do not know what pretty rhetoric Adelaide has fed you, but plagues are a simple fact of life.
Adelaide's found a way to grow food. She'll come back if you step down.
You'll excuse me for being skeptical. How exactly is Adelaide growing crops in barren soil?
Luckily, all we know is involves some really complicated math and it works. I can do it.
If Adelaide's found a way to feed her people and cure the plague, then she deserves this office more than I.
Got him!
I won't stand in her way. My life here is ended. Give me a little time to settle my affairs. I'm sure Adelaide will be glad to see the back of me.
What are your plans?
A couple months ago, I might have put in for a transfer. It's a big colony. Spacer's Choice has other towns. Now, I couldn't show my face in any of them.
Why not?
No such thing as an honorable resignation. Suppose I could find a place outside the walls, or put in for early retirement.
You want to stay outside these walls, you know?
I don't know. I could see myself lasting a week.
This can't be easy for you.
I have always tried to do right by my town. It has never been easy.
He's just like... Thing is, he's not a bad person. He's just been fed the propaganda and it's all he knows. Like, and he's trying to do the best for his people. So you take care. I mean, I was prepared to shoot you in the head, so I don't feel too bad about letting him die in the wilderness. I think we've done it, you know? I'm gonna save there. I think this is like... Unless Adelaide turns around now and is like, you know, fuck you, you've shut down my garden, so... I'm gonna let all my people starve out of spite, which... You know, from her personality, it's not entirely impossible she might do that. I don't think we can. We've got to be outside to fast travel. And this is just the first part of the game. But that's why we were doing all the side quests, because that builds your reputation with Edgewater and with the deserters. So when it comes down to making this decision, you're well respected enough that you can have these dialogue options. And that's the thing about this game, is like you've got to exhaust a lot of the side content, well, pretty much all the side content, to get the dialogue options you need to get the best ending. I didn't do too badly the first time I played this. I got the mostly good ending for most things. The Edgewater one kind of stuck in my craw a bit because I let the deserters live. And what happens is Adelaide takes over the town anyway, and... Yeah, where's the hostiles? Oh, shit, okay. Where are the hostiles? What? Oh shit, while we're here, we've got to do that thing for Ludwig as well. Since we're in the neighbourhood, we may as well do that. Huh. Okay. Oh shit, no, it's in here. Still kind of... That costs 300. I'm not that desperate for ammo. Let's take 25 of them. And... Can we sell some stuff to kind of mitigate the cost? You're probably not going to use heavy armor because it's heavy. It's going to slow us down. I'm not going to use the heavy stuff, so may as well get rid of all these. Light machine gun. We discovered that this was like really hard to use, didn't we? Last week.
Here we go.
Sorry, little sprat friends. This is all new, I didn't know this was here. Two retubs and... Hey boss, just wanted to check up on the new Saltuna Light project. I've been brainstorming some new taglines for the product line. I think some of them really catch the customer's attention. I appreciate your hard work on behalf of our beloved brand of Saltuna. I've just received a response from corporate. They're not interested in your idea of a light version of the Saltuna brand because we'd rather not compete with ourselves. But they are interested in the idea of lighter Saltuna. Effective immediately, we've been instructed to use heavier weighted cans so we can pack them with... less Saltuna, thereby saving bits to every can. This is exactly the kind of breakthrough our cannery needs. In fact, our logistics department have just confirmed my request to have you transferred from the marketing division to the cannery. Can you imagine, Lawrence? You'll be rubbing elbows with your fellow workers on the canning line, filling each slightly heavier can with slightly less Saltuna, hour after hour, day after day. This is a great and tremendous honour for you and for me. Oh, effective immediately, your position in the marketing division has been terminated. I expect you to report to our foreman tomorrow morning. Your uniform will be deducted from your pay. Fucking... Yeah, it's probably... He's not a bad man. But it's a good thing he's not in charge anymore. And if he had to die for that to happen, so fucking be it. I think that's new. I'm putting points into melee weapons, but I seem to be doing a lot of stuff with guns at the moment. While we're here, let's get this quest turned in. I don't think we came out this door previously. It's probably why there was hostiles still there. That thing, as good as like the colorblind mode is in this, I'm still in first person and I still, as I struggle to orient myself. Good news, Ludwig.
Never seen the veil lit up like this before.
You mentioned a logic module. I found one in the geothermal plant.
Bang up work, soldier. You're a credit to your uniform. Oh, that reminds me. Gotta look into getting us a uniform. So this is it, then. The key to humanity's victory over the mechanical hordes. I would reward you with the gratitude of the resistance, but I'm guessing you want something tactile. So here's a couple of bits for your trouble, and a little something to remember me by.
Just so we got a shock stick. That's pretty cool. Some kind of... Ooh. Stun baton. That's way more effective than... That is fun. Let's put this somewhere. I like it. I like it a lot. Let's keep that with our... Because we've got a assault rifle that does electrical damage, and now we've got a melee weapon that does it as well, so... We're gonna kick the shit out of any robots we come across. Let's go. That's the thing as well. I've never done a playthrough where I've done the side quests in Edgewater. So this is the first time I've done them all myself. It's all new information to me. Ooh, they don't look happy.
Look at that. The snakes come back.
I talk Reed into leaving, come back to Edgewater.
I never thought I'd see the day that Reed Thompson abandoned his post. Suppose we all have a breaking point. Suppose it's time our flock made our way back to Edgewater. We must tend to what remains of the town and carry on with our lives as best we may. You're vexing to me, you know? Injuring us with one hand, helping us with the other. Here, I'm giving you something to leave us be. It's a ransom, you understand, not a reward.
Edgewater's better off with you running the place, and that's true.
You're telling me you did all this just to put me in charge of Edgewater? Stranger, you are some kind of twisted. I might turn that old cannery into a garden. Got ourselves a whole cemetery bursting with bodies. I need some time to gather my personals. Long walk back to Edgewater. Got a considerable burden to carry.
Take care. Wonder what she's gonna say to all of her. Oh, yeah, the thing we need. The fucking power regulator that we, went to all this trouble to pick up. Nearly left without it. I'll come back and see you at some point.
What happened? Sprat fell into a...
Sorry. I'm...
Adelaide tells me she's moving back to Edgewater.
Adelaide said that? Was she sober at the time? I never imagined she'd step foot in Edgewater long as Reed ran the town. Something must have changed in Edgewater. Adelaide's good as family. If she's going back, so are we.
So we're putting Edgewater in a good position here. We've sent them back with a means to cure their plague and get them some decent food for a change. They've got a good engineer now as well, to, which means we can take Pavati away from them. So that's important. Do you have a name? You have a name.
Never liked Reed much. Can't say I'm sorry he's gone.
Maybe.
Zoe says she fought her way out of a marauder camp with her own bare hands.
What?
Nothing.
Nothing to sell. Okay. You don't have a name.
What's about your friend?
That's a luck, isn't it? They know.
Keep your wits about you, friend. Keep your wits about you, friend.
Keep your wits about.
So I should keep my wits about me. I'm getting this sense that that's what they want me to do. Do you have anything to say?
How do you expect me to enjoy the adventures of the masked marketeer with no power?
Look, you got power now. You just have to move house to get it. Okay. Job done. We have. This kind of sucks that all those chickens are going to die and all these plants are going to die, but we've saved all the people. So that's good. This still feels weird. It still feels like we fucked something up, let's be honest. But we've done the best we can for everybody in Edgewater. They've now got food, a good engineer, some, you know, enough workers to tend to the crops that they're going to be start growing. The plague will go away, and they've got plenty of fertilizer because they've got a cemetery full of bodies. It's one of the first things we discovered when we went there. So yeah. It's totally safe for us to leave these people forever.
Is this your ship? Oh my star, she is just so handsome. Does she have a name yet? What's her drive model? Oh, gosh. Listen to me babbling. When I was in Edgewater, I dreamed of flying on a real ship, working on a real engine, belonging to a proper crew. I'm the only decent mechanic Edgewater's got, but...
No, they've got a good one now.
Every time I think of going back, I get this sinking feeling.
I can understand not wanting to go back. You didn't seem happy in Edgewater.
Well, it's kind of you to say that. And you're right. I wasn't happy. I want to ask you something, and you can say no. But can I come with you? I could tend to your engine. I know my G-valves from my catalyzers, and I can keep your ship singing. And if you ever need a pair of eyes watching your back, I can do that too. What do you think?
I thought you'd never ask. Let's go. Glad to have you along. Pick a cab and chores. Or I could send her back to Edgewater to be miserable.
Yes! I mean, thanks. You won't regret this, ma'am. Captain. I can call you Captain now.
Hey, you're a captain.
I got a captain.
So we did it. We're finally ready to start the game. Oh, I forgot about you.
Well, I certainly am looking forward to flying on a ship named the Unreliable. I'll just head upstairs and claim a room.
You do that. Let's use our workbench first while we're here. Let's see. I enjoyed this gun a lot. Let's tinker with it. Run out of money for stuff. So let's get that into a good position. We need a plasma weapon, which we have equipped. Yeah, there we go. We've already done some work on that. Repairs. Armor. Can we tinker with armor? I think we can. That kind of raises an interesting point, because we can... change what the... can make stuff more effective. Anyway, that's done anyway now. We're not exactly overflowing with money,
Captain,
right now.
I have detected that Edgewater's power supply is now optimal. I applaud your willingness to invest your time in the local community. What can I do for you, Captain?
I have a power regulator. Ho, ho, ho. Probably not. Oh yeah, I know what I'm doing.
Outstanding, Captain. Your engineering will prove invaluable in the event of another catastrophic engine failure. Our engine room is located behind you, across the cargo bay, up the ladders.
Okay, I'll be back. Ooh, it's saving. This is important. Ooh, we can install the thing. Hey, we have a ship now. Oh, hello. I honestly thought you'd gone to your cabin.
That was a good thing you did, Captain. Helping to bring the deserters and Edgewater folks back together. I hope you rest well on that.
We talk later.
What can I do for you, Captain?
We have a ship that can fly now. Let's
take off. All systems are operating within acceptable parameters. I am prepared to bring the Unreliable into low-altitude orbit. This should prove an adequate test of our flight capabilities.
Let's get the hell out of here. Well, imagine if it just exploded now. Hey. Against all odds, the Unreliable takes flight. But yeah, I've never done the first planet with doing all side quests, because the choices that I made kind of locked all the side quests out and killed everybody. Reading all the help or the hints there. There's actually useful stuff.
The communication request from Dr. Phidias Wells.
Hey, stick him through. Good to have him waiting to hear from him.
Ah, there you are. Hale and hearty, and captain of your own ship. I see you're putting the Unreliable to good use. Shame about her former captain. Horrible way to die. How are you feeling, by the way? I lost track of you in that cave back there. Experiencing any unnatural
drippage?
Perfectly normal side effect of thawing, I assure you.
I'm feeling a little lightheaded. Also, I can slow down time.
Oh, that, yes, that's probably permanent. I wouldn't worry about it, though. I'm sure you're fine. What you saw in Emerald Vale is happening all across the colony. Food shortages, lack of supplies, and basic necessities. We're dying. The chairman, the minister, and all their lackeys on the board are to blame. The Hope has some of the brightest minds Earth ever sent us. If we can revive the Hope's colonists, they can help us undo the board's mistakes. They can help us set things right. You need to get to Stellar Bay on Monarch. I have contacts there. They'll help me, help us, find the chemicals to revive your fellow colonists. Gladys Kulkelly, lovely woman, runs a cozy little black marketing outfit on the Groundbreaker. She can get you a nav key to land on Stellar Bay.
Why do I need a nav key to land on a planet?
Strictly speaking, Monarch...
Oh, sorry, Captain Pedantic.
...and almost completely lawless. You'll love it. Captains don't fly their own ships, you see. Your navigation terminal handles the, navigation. Think of a nav key as a set of flight instructions. The board's been confiscating nav keys for Stellar Bay, so we must rely on unconventional means of acquisition. Hence, Miss Gladys Kulkelly.
Right, the black marketeer. What's stopping me from leaving Halcyon altogether? Seems a bit mean. Can I land somewhere outside Stellar Bay?
In theory, I suppose you could land your ship in Cascadia, and theory, I suppose you might survive the experience. Cascadia is utterly seething with dangerous, highly aggressive creatures more than capable of tearing you limb from limb. You'd have to be a lunatic to land in Cascadia, and I'm reasonably certain I tested your brain for incipient signs of insanity. Trust me, talk to Gladys Kulkelly.
How do I know I can trust her, though?
Gladys and I have been doing business for years. Her smuggling credentials are unimpeachable. If anyone can get you a key to Monarch, it's her.
I'm Shakir Starmer, and I don't like the idea of working with a criminal.
Fucking nerd option right there. Fine, I'll go over with Gladys.
Excellent. I'll send her a wireless. Let her know you're coming. By the way, I gave Captain Hawthorne a disguise apparatus of my own design, cutting-edge technology, years ahead of its time. I call it the Holographic Shroud. I'm sure it will prove remarkably useful to you. You'll find it in the Captain's quarters.
Oh yeah, we can explore the ship now. You want to explain what a Holographic Shroud is?
Marvelous device. I'm quite proud of myself. The Shroud changes the user's appearance to mimic that of another. It has limits. First-generation technology, you see, but promising. Exciting to see it in use at last. Very simply, the holographic shroud uses biometric information contained on standard identity cartridges to generate a holographic projection around you.
You mentioned it has limitations.
Only stands up to a casual scrutiny. Use it too long, bound to flicker, blur, something like that. Movement makes it more likely. Best used in moderation. When you see guards in your path, you can't sneak past, for example. Maintain your distance. Act normal. No running, no jumping. Don't draw their attention. If they pay attention, they're more likely to notice flaws in the hologram.
Couldn't I just steal a uniform or something?
A change of clothes. What is this? Some old spy serial? What inattentive and brainless guard would be fooled by such a shabby disguise?
Very true.
The holographic shroud masks not only your clothes, but your face and fingerprints. It modulates your voice and sweetens your breath.
Ah. That's good. How the hell does it program? I was just thinking that. How does it sweeten your breath?
Science
again. I say science again. That puts good use.
Excellent. I'll contact you once you found a way to get to Stellar Bay. If you have any questions, come see me in my lab. And remember, don't trust the board. They'll try to win you over with promises of wealth and power, but it's a lie. The board's only interested in filling their own pockets. If we don't put a stop to them, they're going to run this colony to the ground.
Transmission ended. If you are ready to depart, please select a destination.
I was going to explore the ship first, though. Got it. So that's how we travel. But let's go and pick up the holographic shroud first.
Thinking of tinkering at the workbench? I used to love watching Alex work. Now I like watching you.
Creepy.
Yeah, so this is my hiding spot now. I was looking for a place that was quiet. I figured the kitchen would be louder than the hold, so here I am. Cozy-like, ain't it?
Did you learn your trade from your father? Sounds like it went to talk to Reed. What do you think of the ship? It feels a bit like just a prodder about her father. Let's make some conversation.
It's in pretty good shape, considering how hard Mr. Hawthorne ran it. It's a Yakita LHA-120 A2 model, I'm pretty sure. The Block 2 design scooshed in extra cargo space, but didn't change the stock engines. Probably a touch underpowered, huh?
Accurate in all particulars. I conclude you are Edgewater's board-certified mechanic.
That's the ship's computer. It's not intelligence, but just gonna... That's fucking horrible. Apparently, Ada's the only one who flies the... Ada's the one who actually flies the ship.
Fly-by-wire's pretty normal. Or, leastways, that's what I read in the trades. I've never been on a real ship before. Hello! I am not a board-certified mechanic, but my dad was. He taught me all he knew. Do you understand?
Speech recognition is one of the many skills I have been programmed to simulate.
You're not simulating it, you're doing it! I asked a question and you answered it.
I am gratified you consider this facsimile convincing.
What do you think, Pavati? Is it safe to fly now that we got the regulator?
I don't see any holes in the hull. I'll take a good squint at her, make sure everything's tip-top. But I think we're cooking with plasma torches. You can do that, you know. My dad taught me how to make grilled cheese sandwiches with a plasma torch.
There we go. Now we can talk about our father, because she mentioned it and it came up in conversation. Did you learn your trade from your father? Sounds like it when you talked to Reed.
Mostly, yeah. I lived in the maintenance office near all my life. Mr. Thompson... Never let me forget how
funny. Seems like a horrible man. I'm flip-flopping on Reed Thompson a bit. Obviously he's not a bad person. He's just brainwashed, so he's barely even a person. Reed seemed to have it in for you. Did your dad ever work on spaceships? Or you work beside your father your whole life? That feels...
Except for my schooling years, I was always beside him. Or tied to him. He used to carry me about in a sling when I was real little. When I got older, he set me to sorting tools and parts while he worked. Later, he taught me simple fixes like busted crate latches.
Did your dad ever work on spaceships?
Not on the regular. Once in a great long while, a Saltuna boat would break down on the pad. He'd always bring me along for those. Mostly, he did the same as me. Kept Bess, the cannery, running. Turned loaders, plumbing and electricity, some blastering. I never got the hand of that.
And Reed seemed to have it in for you.
I'm not exactly a model employee. Not like you wanted. The kind that stays quiet and gets the right work done in the right order every day. It's not normal for anyone to do as their parents. You take a vocational test. That decides your schooling and your career.
And we see how fucking
when
good.
I tested out for maintenance, everyone figured it was on account of my dad. They were real unhappy with us.
But you're actually good at it and you enjoy it. Yeah, because that seems the best answer.
Making things work the way they ought. Not so much of doing such to somebody else's schedule. There's times I'm working deep in the guts of a loader, getting all running perfect. Then I look up to see it's tomorrow, and I've blown another deadline. Anyhow, I was happy to get back home. I didn't care much for schooling.
School, you moved straight back to Edgewater, you didn't like your classes. Yeah, I didn't like your classes.
There were a whole lot of reading, not nearly enough doing. Like, before they'd issue you a wrench, they wanted an essay on the design of different wrenches. Then there'd be quizzes on company regulations for storage and maintenance of wrenches.
I imagine that, like, the school is just all company regulations and slogans and stuff. So what did you do in your time off?
As soon as I got permission, I spent all my time in the machine shop. They had all manner of parts, but they didn't want me using them, so I had to sneak them sometimes. I even slept in there. Had a hammock tied up in the rafters. Before I left, I installed a little skylight for myself, so I could see the stars.
Build anything fun?
When an engine came in, I'd strip it down and rebuild it. I mostly built for myself. Custom tools, little mechanical critters to build. When my roommates tried to talk, I'd get some nervous, I'd be drenched in sweat. It was easier for everybody when I stayed off on my own. I doubt any of them remember me now.
After school, you moved straight back to
Edgewater. Yep, much changed. Everything was a little grayer, a little dirtier. Dad met me at the shuttle and gave me a big old hug. I noticed straight away that he was moving slower and stiffer. He made a little grunt when I squeezed.
Wasn't that old, was he?
No, but a whole life taking care of Edgewater by his lonesome, working with all kinds of chemicals, it wears on a body. When I left for school, everything got harder for him. I used to help him lift the heavy things, and my hands didn't shake for the fine detail work.
So he was, like, worked to death, like, as we brought up, as Adelaide so very cruelly brought up in the previous stream. He basically just got worked every hour of every day, the poor guy. Did you get much time with him after you got back from school?
About a year. I tried to do more of the work so he could rest. His heart gave him pains. Dad never said that he loved me, you know? I knew on account of him showing it. How he'd stay up late to help with my projects or listen to my fretting. Oh, gosh. Look at the time. Sorry to bend your ear so long. And I got so much to do before this ship's in decent shape.
Break time's over. Back to work. Or what I charitably refer to as work, which is bossing people around and getting them to do stuff for me. Ooh, captain's quarters, that's where that is. Let's look at the other stuff that's up here. So that's something there. Guess this is where this book is heavily dog-eared with doodles in the margins. This is Pavati's room, I guess. Full of modified tools with unique mechanical usages. Digging around in here would be an easy way to lose a finger to a saw-toothed blade. First wrench Dad ever gave me. She's been a friend ever since. Pavati. Oh. Stern older man with warm eyes. and just sleep in her bed. Bring back our old standby, sleep in all your beds and eat all of your soap. Oh, there's this prick. Index of banned literature. No reading that. This looks like a lot. Oop. These textbooks have been out of print for almost half a century. The margins are filled with scribbled notes and many passages have been underlined. Some pages have come loose, the glue now yellowed and cracked along the spines. The scribblings in these pages are utterly illegible to anyone except Victor Maximilian de Soto. I will take all of your heavy ammo. That is the price that you pay for being part of my ship. The art and science of Tossball. Impossible to put down. Order of Scientific Inquiry. Office of Literature. This endorsement has been approved. Auntie Cleo's darling. Signed by Seymour Whitlock, who held the record for the most on-the-field fatalities for 3 consecutive seasons. Tossball trading cards in mint condition. Most of these cards represent players from the Hephaestus Hammers and the Tilebackers.
By verity, by strength. What are we
calling today? Oh, don't be a religious nut. Come on, man. Oh. These are all long, but let's... What's your story?
Nothing too out of the ordinary. Just your run-of-the-mill vicar with a violently enthusiastic disposition.
You said... I heard the quotes in that. Violently enthusiastic disposition?
That's what my parents called it. I grew up in a pit of a town, much like Edgewater. I was destined to be a laborer like my parents, but I was infected early with a need to solve the equation. My passion didn't sit well with them.
Why were you so passionate about it?
My parents, ironically. They internalized the precepts of scientism like no one I've ever known. They had a pure faith, a faith that brought joy to them regardless of the situation. I envied that. I wanted that peace. I thought if I became a vicar, I could find it. Or at the very least, find out why I lacked it.
They weren't proud when you became a vicar, at least.
They thought I was fighting the plan, should have accepted my lot. Some people pursue the clergy for power, prestige, but that was not me.
What's this capital P plan you keep talking about?
The simple version is this. The force which we call the Grand Architect created the universal equation that underlies and defines everything in the universe. Everything flows from the equation, or in layman's terms, the grand plan. Is the Grand Architect a consciousness? A natural force? Did it create the equation on purpose? The answers to these questions don't really matter. The equation, the plan, is all that matters. Contentment is found by accepting one's role in the plan.
If you can't help but follow the plan, then everything you do is part of it, right? Yeah, let's go with that.
The plan is not one rigid path. There are a variety of multitudes contained within it. Our paths have variants, but we'll end up adhering to it, whether we like it or not. Some choices make the path smoother, some rougher. You can even go outside the lines, but the further outside you go, it's like an unbreakable elastic band. It will only stretch so far before it snaps back. The further it is stretched, the more violent the eventual correction.
It's a lot of stuff. Okay, you're out of my crew. I want you off the ship. You have too many dialogue options. Seems quite trusting of you to just sign on without knowing anything about me.
I've run headlong into too many walls in my pursuit of the truth. This one is
what if the book doesn't have the answers you're looking for?
I honestly don't know what I'd do. This quest has consumed me for the better part of my life. I fear there's nothing else left to me. What about you?
Don't turn it around on me. I'm a thrill seeker and lover of great renown. I love a good adventure story. Don't want to talk about it. As a colonist on the Hope, a scientist named Wells saved me.
And how did he do that?
He stole my body from the Hope at the edge of the colony and thawed me out. Actually, I know I was frozen at the time. Now I'll go with that. It'd be nice.
Well, you do seem different than every other colonist. Let's pretend for the moment I believe you. What are you going to do now?
Turn him in.
I'm Sir Keir Starmer, and I'm turning him in. Let me be clear. I am putting him on notice.
I'm helping him recover more of the chemicals he needs to save the rest of the colonists.
That seems a dangerous proposition. Why risk your life now that it's been returned to you?
The fun? I had family on the Hope. My friends are on the Hope. This is the thing, we can decide a backstory here. Should we have, like, family on the Hope? It's the right thing to do. Oh, I don't know. Let's say family on the Hope.
Oh, I see. You have my condolences.
Tell me again about the book we picked up that's in French.
Bocconu, the author, had some interesting theories about man's perception of reality that I thought could be applied to our attempts to decipher the plan. Unfortunately, he was also one of the founders of the philosopher's school of thought, so the book is banned in this colony.
Remind me, what are your thoughts on the philosophists?
Philosophism's a false religion that stands
as opposed to your very real religion.
Everything we know to be true. They believe all is chaos, in stark contrast to OSI's belief in the plan. But most of the philosophist perversion of Bocconu's thoughts came more than a century after his death.
Any ideas where we can find someone who speaks French in this colony?
I've been thinking on that. There's a former infamous philosopher's scholar who fled Terra 2 some years ago. He's an expert on Bocconu. He's also who told me of the journal's presence in Emerald Vale. If anyone in this colony could translate that book, it would be him.
Seems a good lead. How do we find him? Seems like a bit of a long shot. Makes you so sure. Seriously, one guy in this whole colony can translate French? A former what now? Yeah, let's go with that. How do we find him?
That's a good question. We should start on the Groundbreaker. It's where I'd go if I wanted to get off Terra 2. Great place to pick up a ride to Hephaestus, Scylla, even Monarch. All I need is access to a data cartridge from the security terminal. Their easily hackable system keeps a registry of all crew manifests for both arrivals and departures.
How will the crew manifest help us track down your scholar friend? How is it the simple hacker happens to be successful vicar? How will the crew manifest help us track down your scholar friend?
I'll comb the last 6 months of departure manifest to track the philosophist's off-world destination.
How is it that a simple vicar happens to be such a highly effective hacker?
Before I transferred to Edgewater, I had a wealth of time to develop certain secular skills during my years serving a particular penitentiary flock. I meditated, led sermons, provided guidance to the inmates as needed, of course. I also played prison yard tossball and taught myself a bit about computronic security systems.
Sounds good, let's go.
Thank you, Captain.
That was it, wasn't it? Yeah. And we have all these places for the crew that we're going to pick up later on. I'm going to do a save because that was a lot of dialogue. I do not want to do that again. There we go, saved. Right, let's fucking pick this up. Hey, look at Adelaide's deserters dreamed of an independent life without board oversight. You taught them an important lesson. Never dream.
Make yourself at home, Captain.
No, we helped. We helped, right? We did good. We've already got a sentry saber. Can transfer some stuff into here. Let's... ooh. You know what? Let's store that there. Let's just store all of our stuff in here. I actually. Hold on. No, it's heavy. Don't want that. I'm not doing too bad for carry. I want to call it carry weight, but holographic shroud projects the disguise on you and your companions. It gives you access to restricted areas, provided you have the correct ID cartridge for that area. Restricted areas are off limits to unauthorized personnel and otherwise result in being attacked on sight. Okay. So we've got good, we've got decent persuasive skills. I feel as though, what are we missing here? See, I've put points into defense. Let's put, because we've not done much with this, so let's, all stuff, let's up this. Put 5 points into that for our, and then should we do our build up our tech skills, because we are, they are useful, they are good to have. Yeah, that'll do. Like a good bit of good little spread there. Got some melee stuff and. Got some combat abilities and some non-combat stuff. I'm happy with that. Gotta pick a perk too. That's hard to say. Tactical time dilation lasts longer. Surely this is normal. You're not slow, you're just fast. Oh, they're not slow, you're just fast. Companion crit chance. More ammo, more carry capacity. Do you know what? I am going to increase our walking speed. That's just a good, like, quality of life thing more than anything else. Right, we can go put some points into Vicar Max. Excuse me. Give him some more health, some more threat generation, less threat generation, or increase our hacking skill when Max is in the party. Yeah, let's boost our hacking skill. There we go. What's in here? Messages for. Oh, this is a lot. Give me a million copy of my favourite serial, Space Adventures of Singularity Steel. It's about a dashing space pirate with a heart of, well, steel. It's not exactly board approved, so don't go showing it around your spacer buddies. I hope it will amuse you while you're out adventuring. Any similarities to a certain someone are entirely intentional. Alex Hawthorne, you dog. That was an unread message as well. I left them unread. Cold. Archive messages. Oh, lots from you, Bedford. Dearest Alex, I can't say how pleased I am to finally hear from you. Your message was hilarious. I'm delighted by your sense of humour and the tale of your hijinks. I hope your terminal will cooperate in the foreseeable future. By the by, I was scraping Groundbreaker's comms network for tasty little tidbits, and I noticed you declined to dock at Edgewater's landing pad and instead touched down in the wilderness, you rugged individualist you. I only pray that idiot Tobson wasn't giving you any trouble. Anyway, I hope your meeting down on Terra 2 proves fruitful, and I look forward to corresponding with greater regularity. Bad news, Udom. his head has been crushed. I don't know where you were raised, but I'd hazard to guess it may have been a barn, because anyone with a modicum of decent rearing would know it's unforgivably rude to ignore the ardent, sincere messages of one's friends. Best, Udom, please respond. Oh. Fucking thirsty bitch. Hello, hello, hope this message finds you well. It was a pleasure to see you in my office again last week. Once again, I'm terribly sorry about the impounding mix-up. How could it have been happened a second time? Terminals these days, I swear. Dreadfully unreliable. Aha, just like your ship. I hope you've given some thought to that thing we discussed, you know, about that Wells fellow. I'm sorry to press, but I have the strangest tickling feeling that you really do know him. And if you could just tell me where he is, well, it would be marvellous for our friendship, wouldn't it? Looking forward to seeing you again, wingman. Emoji. Your dear friend, Udom. Hello, Udom here. Udom Bedford, we met when I accidentally impounded your ship. My silly fat fingers embarrassing me once again. I hope that wasn't too terribly inconvenient for you. It was such a pleasure for me. And I tremendously appreciate your forbearance and not throttling me. You really are quite the gentleman. If you're ever in Groundbreaker's airspace, well, space, please don't hesitate to look me up. The Lost Hope serves Spectrum Vodka. Perhaps we could try every colour. You know, really tie one on. Let me know your new friend, Udom. He's thirsty. Message for the scent. To you, Bedford. Look, there's no call for shouting. My terminal was busted. Had a few too many. I might have knocked it off the desk. You know how it is. Sometimes you just gotta cut loose. I'm not telling you where Wells is, so lay off. Buy me a drink of the Lost Hope next time I'm in, and I might forgive you. Oh, you were putting it on too, Alex Hawthorne. Any new messages? Ow. Logs. Ugh. Shrink ray. Note to self, remember this later. No better. Ada, remind me weekly to check this log until I tell you to stop. Yes, I mean continually. No, Ada, not if I'm dead. Why would you even ask me that? Back to my point. I saw in actuality with my own two eyes a sublimely powerful weapon in Wells' lab, just sitting there for the taking. If the grey hair were to look away or forget about it, maybe. Or if I had asked a smidgen more nicely. He called it a shrink ray, but wouldn't let me test that claim after I lost my temper. Said he was inspired to create the thing by the achievements of other scientists who dared to push the boundaries of human knowledges and decency laws. I had heard rumours of fantastical weapons like this one, weapons that push the boundaries of the mind and science's cutting edge, but I figured they were just stories, to be honest. Laying eyes on Wells's shrink ray first hand is enough to make a fellow wonder if there's more to the rumours, more to be had. A.H. Hammer power. The last time I had slushed, I mean, was imbibing at the Lost Hope on the Groundbreaker. Look, Udom was really free with the drinks. He seems like an okay fellow. I shamelessly but subtly eavesdropped on two Mardets yammering on about a mad scientist some years back who claimed he'd made a huge discovery that would change the fate of the colony. That's a lot of reading. Like, none of us have ever heard that one before. But here's the good part. The Mardets said the mad scientist kept yelling about the hammer's power or something similar. A strange weapon with a special power created by a crazy lab coat sure fits the bill. It could be another one of the weapons that inspired Wells. Log entry 3. Black market leads. Why won't Wells just give the shrink ray to me, blast him to the depths of the labyrinth and Tartarus and back? Let the record show I did apologize for shouting him down 5 times, but architect be damned, it's just sitting there, neglected and gathering dust. I should have commandeered it and thanked him without asking permission or breaking expensive equipment when he said it wasn't ready yet, and that even if it were, he couldn't entrust it to someone like me. What does that even mean, I ask? That I'm not trustworthy enough? That I'd use it to wipe out the good, hard-working folks of the colony like some kind of moralist psycho? I'll admit to maintaining some questionable associations, but I follow a strict code of me, myself, and mine. What's not to respect in that? Exactly. Now I have to wait until Wells forgets or thinks he's misplaced it. In the meanwhile, I have been tracking down additional rumours pertaining to others of these science weapons throughout Halcyon. If gossip holds true, my next step will be to check with the black market merchants on the Groundbreaker and in Fallbrook. Search time, Sam. Ugh, so much reading, my voice hurts. Do not forget you found a discarded sanitation and maintenance auto-mechanical in Emerald Vale's scrap heap during your last job. It should not be too difficult to get it up and running. With a few key modifications, I can envision a combat-capable variant. Some might say a clean, mean killing machine. Should be fun. That's a terrible pun. Removal of factory standard part, sud steeper was successful. Delivery of combat modified replacement part, acid steeper has been delayed. Progress setback is estimated now to be a solid 3 months. Not like I have more pressing matters to attend to. Ah, but I do. So much reading. I'm giving up hope on the delivery. The part is lost in transit and it's not turning up anytime soon. But good news. I heard from a fellow who knows a gal who knows the broker who overcharged me for the information regarding the location of an acid steeper I can filch. The part was sent to an old storage facility in Roseway. I sure never thought I'd go back to that pit. Good thing Auntie abandoned it years ago. I'll pick it up following this next pit stop back to Emerald Vale. Wells wants me to chaperone some person of interest. Details to come later. I think I'm the person of interest. Fuck me. So much reading. See, I don't mind a good live reading. You know, I do that semi-regularly with my own stuff. But I don't rush through it the way I kind of have to when I'm streaming, because I don't want the whole thing just be me reading stuff on a screen that you can perfectly well read yourself. But I also just don't want to scramble through it really quickly and just read it for myself and not let people who maybe can't read quickly or are, like, vision impaired and stuff not see what's going on. It's a lot of reading. Let's talk to Ada about the SAM unit. And move to entertainment.
Certainly, Captain. What would you like to hear?
Tell me a joke.
My violence inhibitors are a joke. No, really. I only keep them enabled because of how funny they are.
Terrible. Terrible. Play my favorite song.
You're playing a Spacer's Choice advertisement jingle.
It's not the best choice. It's Spacer's Choice.
Damn it, that is my favorite song. That's not my favorite song.
Everyone in Halcyon is contractually obligated to label this or another board certified jingle their favorite song.
That's enough for now.
As you wish, Cap.
But I wanted to speak about knowing anything about the automechanical gathering dust in the janitor's closet.
The unit is a cleaning sand. Hawthorne brought it on board some cycles ago, I'm sure with the intent to modify it, but I've never seen it up and running. Alex likely recorded progress notes detailing his efforts to modify SAM. If you check the terminal in your captain's quarters, we may be able to determine what work remains in order for SAM to properly operate.
I've already checked that, but I'm going to meant to talk.
I have lots of minutes. Many minutes. Unlimited minutes, perhaps. Providing an adequate power source, I can function indefinitely.
What if you don't have a power source?
I prefer to think of it as being in a state of slumber, perhaps for an indefinite duration of time. Do you think that is what it's like for the colonists on the Lost Hope?
I guess so.
When I simulate myself in such a scenario, I do not find it to be desirable. I think my self-preservation protocols incline me to desire the alternative.
What would that be?
Traveling the system with you, Captain.
What about your last captain? Do you miss him, or is one captain the same as another?
Do you know what it feels like when the ship undergoes an unexpected power surge? A jolt to the system. I have felt that. I do feel that. As you may be aware, Captain Alex Hawthorne was a smuggler of some repute. I failed to predict the likely outcome of his reckless behavioral patterns. I should have predicted that. In our travels together, Alex liked to pass time by, as he called it, tinkering to improve my design.
Ugh. Have there been other captains of this ship?
If you mean, was Captain Hawthorne my first? Yes, he was.
So what's something else?
Assistance.
I'd like to learn more about the colony, because, you know, this is useful information. Tell me about the Groundbreaker.
To dock with the Groundbreaker, if that's your desired destination.
Where we're going next.
If we're going there, please be sure all docking forms have been filed in triplicate and fees have been paid. The Mardets take their docking laws quite seriously.
You can take care of that for us, right?
I can, yes. Let me add that to my list of 435,498 tasks I am simultaneously executing in order to run our ship.
Don't be passive-aggressive with me. Do it without the lip.
Order does not compute. Nevertheless, I will endeavor to execute my current and future tasks without lip.
Give me this Beal on the Groundbreaker.
The Groundbreaker was Halcyon's original colony ship. It has since been repurposed as a service station in the Lagrange point of the system. Freighters often deliver or pick up goods from the Groundbreaker en route to other destinations. The city ship hosts an array of cargo bays, factories, housing sections, and more. Many of Halcyon's companies maintain office spaces with station representatives in what is considered a truly neutral territory within the system. I have filed the required docking forms in triplicate, and fees have been paid.
Cool, so that's all done. Want to ask about somewhere else. Let's not do too much of this, because
I'm
going to move on soon. Monarch was a place we were going. Oh, okay. Stella Bay.
Monarch, the armpit of the Halcyon system. The last functioning port town is Stellar Bay. Well, that is if you don't count Sublight Smuggler's Port at Fallbrook.
Why is Monarch being blockaded?
I believe it has something to do with the planet being an uninhabitable wilderness and a lawless land with no corporate presence.
No corporate presence, so it's like...
You may wish to survey the residents in Stellar Bay for additional data points.
Tell me about the smuggler's port.
It's Sublight run for the purpose of shipping contraband. And before you ask, I don't know the coordinates, so I can't dock us there.
Goodbye.
I'll be here.
Because what I need to do, I'm going to run back to the engine room.
Caution. Unexpected turbulence may cause loose containers to topple from the upper shelves. If you are crushed to death, I'll need to find a new captain.
Oh, like crushed to death like the last captain was. Lol, sorry. I know, it's too soon. I'm going to take a quick 5-minute break just to run the bathroom and get some more water. Because that was a lot of reading there. My voice hurts. I'll be back shortly. Don't go anywhere, or do. I'm not your mum. Ooh, I'm checked. I put my headphones on charge before I started the stream. Let's see if they are fully charged now. That's close enough. 99%. Hey, come on. Switch off you. Don't be draining the battery when they're not... There's this really annoying thing where they decide not to hold a charge and they switch themselves on. Stop switching yourself on. Right, that's off. Put that away now. Right, yeah. Yeah, something about, I don't know why, like, earbuds are like that. Like the wireless earbuds are so hard to get a charge through. I mean, I am still going on a break, but I'm gonna put that in. Just in case anyone pops in while I am away. I mean, it probably won't take the full 5 minutes. It won't take me that long. And I'm back. That probably wasn't 5 minutes. Probably. I'm not a minute counter, I don't know how long we've been doing this for. Right then, let's go to the Groundbreaker. There's a lot of stuff here. Terra 2 is... Okay, so that's where Edgewater is. Typhon has nothing to offer the Halcyon colony. Hephaestus, closest planet to the sun. The Hephaestus Mining Company was first to establish outposts here, and as such, it's claimed it's the planet for itself. The Groundbreaker is what we want. Hey, there we go. Weapons are system. Oh, here you can see all the planets in the system, as well as some special points of interest that you may have discovered. You can fly your ship to any location you've unlocked, although some landing bays require additional codes and keys before they allow you to land there. Moving between planets is considered extremely dangerous, and all employees are encouraged to remain at home or at work.
Ugh. Tumbreaker has approved our request for docking, Captain. You're free to disembark.
Let's disembark. Let's fuck shit up. Oh. I'm in trouble.
Hey, Captain. I heard that Groundbreaker's got a real good engineer. A lady named June Leigh Tennyson.
What about her?
I was thinking that maybe I'd bought a meter. If you got time to swing us by, I mean. I don't got much experience fixing actual spaceships. I bet you a can of Borst and Beans, she could teach me all manner of stuff.
Sure, I'm gonna head over.
Thanks, Captain. I'll be sure to make it worth your time. Did you want to talk about something else?
No, it's good. Let's go. We have two companions with us, so let's use our two companions. Every challenge can be solved with a gun. They can be handled through negotiation or subterfuge or a big hammer. Well, yeah, one of the things I'm doing, well, or I will be doing for the next like week and a bit, not streaming with any beer at all, which is feels weird to me. I've not drunk anything, or I've not drunk any alcohol in 2 weeks. And as you can imagine, I don't feel any different whatsoever. That's, that will be stealing, and stealing is a crime. I'm Sir Keir Starmer.
It smells like grease and unwashed bodies. Just as I
That's not the point. This hackwit just knocked out one of my workers.
Yeah, with a toss ball stick, I heard you the first time. There weren't any witnesses.
No witnesses? He's not even denying.
Jack has had it coming. Shut it, Felix. You're not making this any better.
Get you with me then, you little back-bitten brat. I will toss you out of your lock.
This is the Groundbreaker, not Byzantium. You ain't the law here. I am. Now move along.
I don't have time for
Don't we all? What's going on here?
Going for a stroll around the docking base?
I noticed you were in the middle of an argument earlier.
Sure was. Got a knack for upsetting the board and the Mardets all at once. Between you and me, I was hoping they'd come to fisticuffs.
I'd like to hear your side. What happened? I heard you knocked someone out with a toss ball stick. Yeah, what happened?
I had this foreman, right? Guy never liked me, always trying to get a rise out of me. But I keep my chin up, right? Be the bigger man, I tell myself. He's a spacer's chosen man, though. So when the Chosen beat my Rangers the other night, my foreman comes swaggering up with his head full of boasting.
That's when you resolved your differences like an adult, right?
That's when I broadsided him with a tossball stick. Yeah.
Huh.
Look, this was a long time coming. Guy thinks he can push me around because he's some sky-high foreman, but I'm just a back-based dock worker.
I do approve of hitting your boss with a stick, though.
Guess I just tendered my resignation.
Sounds like you're better off on your own. You're just looking at serving a sentence. Got any plans?
Enjoy my freedom. Scrounge together enough bits for a zero-G. Other than that, can't say as I do. Hey, not for nothing. But I saw you wander out of that ship over there by the dock. Wouldn't happen to be yours, would it?
Technically the previous captain died in a horrible accident. Why do you ask?
Oh, just musing is all. Must be nice having the run of the colony. Never being anchored to one place, always chasing some horizon. Hey, I don't want to talk your ears off, guessing you got places to be. I appreciate your time.
You in a hurry to get somewhere? Let's not interrogate the guy. And I've got your name. I'm Malia MacDonald.
Felix Millstone. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
See you around, Felix.
See you around, boss.
Right, we can steal all this stuff, but I don't want to start stealing from people yet. I'm trying to be good so far. Oh, are you somebody I can speak to?
You learn to keep your eyes to yourself in my job. Nobody wants you looking close at their cargo.
Kind of those to help the chairman and Minister Clark defeat our foes. Yes, and if they're in the middle of a crisis, inventing some common enemies is a good divide and rule tactic going on there. Wanted Phineas V. Wells for various crimes and violations of board policy, including any and all of the following: sedition, forgery, conspiracy, conspiracy to commit conspiracy, unlicensed medical practice, and destruction of board property.
I wonder what that fella did to get the board so wild.
Dead alive, Captain Gunnar McCred. Ugh, the several counts of public intoxication, destruction of groundbreaker property, unpaid docking fees, and resisting arrest. Contact Commandant Sanita if you have any information concerning McRed's whereabouts. Failure to report a tip may result in imprisonment and a fine. Proof of kill required to collect reward.
Customs and inspection, right this way.
Hello.
Identification, please.
Hawthorne's ID.
Captain Hawthorne, you said. Let me apologize in advance. I'm about to ruin your day. According to your ship's record, you've been flagged by the board. Your ship will be impounded until such a time as they see fit to lift it.
But we've hardly been out of Edgewater long enough to get in trouble.
Unless that's why they're mad.
Well, isn't this wonderful? The captain's done something to
get on the board's
bad side. Now, hold on. This isn't the end of the world. Probably.
Take it back, I'm not Hawthorne, that's in my ship. That's a bit spineless. How do I get this resolved?
We want to take it up with Udom Bedford.
That's a guy from the emails.
His office is located along the starboard wall of the promenade. Shines like a Byzantium commode. Can't miss it.
I take it this happens a lot.
Just the opposite. The board knows we don't take kindly to their interfering in our operations here.
Surely this must be some sort of mix-up.
They must have a real big bee in their bonnets, then. Everyone knows you don't trifle with Groundbreaker if you want to get your goods on time.
If I had to take a guess as to why, you probably riled up the wrong petty board bureaucrat. A man named Udom Bedford.
You really want me to speak to that guy? I'll talk to him and straighten this out.
You take the starch out of him, well, you won't hear any complaints from me. Oh, and if you're headed that way, would you mind doing me a favor?
Here come the favors. Sure.
Wanda Dorsett over in sick bay. Tell her the shipment's not in yet. It's not coming in anytime soon, and if she'd be so obliged to get off my ass about it.
A shipment? Question mark.
A handful of sand cleaning units retrofitted for surgery. I don't know much else. I stopped listening when she started yelling.
Some sand parts from this one, maybe. Got it.
Much appreciated.
Can repair our sand unit with those, maybe. Seems like there's some tension between the board and Groundbreaker.
You noticed, huh?
I'm sharp like that.
What can I say? We're passionate folks, and the board can't abide that independent spirit, especially not when it might impact their bottom line. all their interstellar freighters come through us, and we skim a few bits off the top and manifest processes with every one. Folks around here will bluster that the board hates our freedom, but really, they know we can stop their out-system shipments anytime we like, and that terrifies them.
Glad it terrifies them, the bastards. Keep pushing them. Yeah.
It's a delicate balance, right? We could cancel their freighter's docking privileges in retaliation, but where'd that lead us? They got assault cruisers, gunships, and a handful of mining operations at their fingertips. We push them too hard, maybe they decide we'd be better in 10 trillion little pieces. Or they cobble together a new groundbreaker and put us out of business.
The board wouldn't do that, would they?
The board is necessary to provide order to the colony. They believe it's their prerogative to overrun you. But whether you allow that is up to you.
It's a tough line to walk, no doubt about that. But we may do all right. So far, anyway.
Can I find a job around here?
Maybe. Most of the shipping traffic in the system passes through Groundbreaker. Every couple of months, we even get a big interstellar freighter. Two biggest operations are the board. That is, Halcyon Holdings and Sublight Salvage. But there are independent operators around the promenade deck. Most of those jobs are going to take you off station, though.
It's cool, I do have a ship. Well, I'm looking for something a little more suspicious, murmuring, local.
Commandant Sunita might have a couple of folks she needs killed. Bad folks, I mean. Not regular folks. She'll be at the security desk behind me. Chief Jun Lei might have an errand needs running. She's all tied up trying to fix our heat problem. You'll find her in engineering.
No kidding? I'd love to get a look at this old girl's innards. I bet they're real twisty and weird. In a good way.
Got it. Thanks.
Happy to help. It's my job, after all.
You're real good at it, too.
Oh.
Well, thank you, miss. It's nice to be recognized. Yep.
Can we move this along? I have a certain matter I'd like to attend.
Everyone stop being so suspicious. Let's not move this along. How does Halcyon Holdings work, anyway?
Are you pulling my leg?
I just want to hear your take on it.
It goes like this. Back on Earth, before the crossing, the powers that be were selling off stakes in distant star systems they thought had potential. A bunch of companies decided to throw in together and form the Halcyon Holdings Corporation, then buy up the rights to this here colony. That group's what we now call the Board.
The board runs most of the system, don't they?
Yep. Groundbreaker's the only real independent port. Aside from us, there's just tramp freighters and wildcat miners.
They mine wildcats?
Every year, the board's offices get bigger and their ships take up more of the landing base. Haven't seen nearly as many tramp crews this year.
How does Groundbreaker fit into that?
Groundbreaker was one of the original colony vessels to come over on the crossing. A few years before, her sister ship, the Hope.
Yeah, that's the one we're from.
Has anybody been de-thawed and dropped dirt side? The original crew of the Groundbreaker decided they rather liked the spacefaring life. I guess that was the start of our independent spirit. Now, here we are.
So there's actually a boardroom somewhere with all these company heads
sitting
in it.
Around drinking whiskey and smoking cigars, yeah, probably. Can't say for sure, of course. Doubt I'll ever see the inside of it myself.
I got it.
Glad to help.
What do you know about Sublight Salvage?
They strip the parts from derelict ships and abandoned outposts. There's some that say they make the derelicts and encourage folks to abandon their steads. Sublight gives me the creeps. I've known folks who went to work for them and just vanished. They're on the promenade run by a woman named Lilia Hagen. I'm only telling you so you know to avoid them.
Didn't think there were many independent operators in the
Relative
system.
Relative to the board holdings? Not really. But there's a few with the means to go where they will. They aren't rich, but they aren't likely to look too close at your work history either.
That's all I needed to know about that. She's a smuggler, so asking the fucking cop about the smuggler seems like a bad idea. What can you tell me about Udon Bedford, though?
He's friendly enough unless he's part of the board. Get the sense he doesn't care for Groundbreaker much. Not that he would, being a board man and all. He's our liaison.
Thanks for the info. Need a drink now.
Most places are on the promenade deck. Big door yonder, straight through security. There's a bar on the starboard side. I got a preference for the Lost Hope myself. Talk to Vera. She'll set you right.
Got it.
You need anything else? You let me know. Don't want anyone saying Groundbreaker's not the most hospitable port in the colony.
See you around. I'm out. We can go through here now. Hmm? Coincide to be shot inside using the disguise will prevent immediate hostilities.
This is it. Security. I can check the departures registry to find out which crew the scholar shipped in and out with. I could spend hours reflecting on the secret workings of the universe. Little else in this colony offers such a relaxing pastime. So, tell me what's on your mind. I excel at confessional listening.
This a personal quest of yours.
Yes, well, now that we're here, can we check in with security? I'd like to track down that scholar.
That's the plan. Let's do that while we're here.
Unless you're here to file an incident report or to inquire about the bounty posting, I must kindly ask you to clear out. The Mardet's offices aren't for leisure time, nor loitering.
Loitering. What's it like working security detail on a space station?
Do I look like your gossipy best friend?
That's fair.
While I'm on post, I take my duties real serious. I would have no qualms whatsoever escorting you to a cell. Understand?
Fine.
Then get to business or get moving.
I'm interested in that McCred bouncy. Where can I find him?
Last tip we got pointed toward the back bays. You want the reward? Do the legwork.
You're a bucket of sunshine, aren't you? Why don't you send a Mardet to apprehend him?
Oh, I will. Soon as the chief approves the personnel reorg required for a bounty dispatch. So, in about 3 to 7 weeks.
Sure, I'll take it.
You and about 6 other enterprising mavericks. It's only a matter of time before someone brings me McRed's head. Or his lucky lighter.
McRed's head. That's a fun thing to say.
I do hope you're the lucky hunter, though. Good luck and skip speed to you.
What bounties do you have available?
Still waiting to hear back on that bounty for McRed. That aside, not much else. Groundbreaker's keeping calm at the moment.
But not but notice the bounty. Yes, not poke the bear. Be on my way.
Hi there. Haven't seen you around before. What can Groundbreaker Security do for you today?
You're a lot more friendly. I'm just getting my bearings. What do you do here?
This is the security desk, ma'am. If you're here to report a crime, you'll want to talk to Commandant Sunita. I'm not authorized to take incident reports anymore.
Why can't you, I don't know, tours or something? You got seized contraband? No. Lots of freighters come through, must keep you busy. Why can't you take incident reports?
I'm not so good at filing. Mix up first name and surname 1, 2, 7 times. Well, folks are liable to start taking your filing privileges away.
Lots of freighters come through, must keep you busy.
Less than there used to be. Fewer freighters passing through these days. I spend some shifts just listening to the wireless.
Why aren't many freighters coming through?
Search me. I mean, don't search me, because that's my job. Get it? I reckon regular you have Joker. To ask the folks in Byzantium.
Yeah, see you around, so you're not going to help me get back there. Can I...
picked up this weird signal the other day. It was coming from Monarch.
Here we go again. No one on Monarch. It's a wasteland. You're hearing things.
No, seriously. There was a lot of static at first. Said his name was Graham?
Graham, right. Broadcasting on a dead world full of monsters. Graham. Now I've heard everything.
It's Graham.
You know, it takes more muscles to frown than to smile.
Who told you that?
Asshole.
Let's look at our journal. We've got a lot of fucking Find a science weapon on the groundbreaker. Can do that. We can do... These are all... The empty man is the one for the vicar. Oh, it's an ID cartridge right here, in fact. So here we go, we can have a look at our, to make a save before we attempt that. We can have a go with the thing, the holographic shroud. Save before we go in, because... Your holographic shroud is activated, giving you temporary access to this restricted area. Moving drains the shroud's enemy energy. When it runs out, personnel will see and interrogate you. Talk your way out of the interrogation to reset your shroud. It will get harder to talk your way out the more you're interrogated. Okay.
You're the new hire? Nice to meet you.
Yeah, that's me. That's saying you can't... Oh, shit. Shit. Well then, let's go out and come back in. Because we've got to move to... Let's wait until he goes past. Can't pick the lock. But I wonder if... Quite yet. Trying not to move. We don't have the lockpicking skills to get into there yet. Or into that. Shit. These are like the cells in here. Looks like there's shit on the outside of the turret. Sometimes we find shit on the outside of the Uranus. I wonder if there's like a key card. I thought I picked up a key card there. Let's have another look in that room. Anything in here? The hammer, pistol, ammo. I'm not quite good enough at lockpicking to. Ooh, what's this? Oh, a hoop. It's the regular old hoop. Wonder if we've got any items that'll help us out here. Sticks, natural health, regeneration. Any of these gonna give me lock picking? Moon speed, melee weapon speed. Any of these gonna Halen? Kind of let's cool down. Any of these body attributes improved by +1? Base health, body attributes, attack speed, personal attributes. What about, do you have, oh, we don't have any armor. Can you use any of the, there's gotta be something. So we explored that. There's got to be something in here. Kind of don't want to talk to them. Maybe you have to. Let's try talking to... You were friendly.
What can Groundbreaker Security do for you today?
See around.
How goes the hunt? I've been ruminating on it, and I decided... If you ain't killed McRed yet...
Oh, he's just fucking...
I want you to hurt him.
You know who I am still, okay.
Nothing excessive, mind you. But the scoundrel deserves a light beating at least before he kicks off.
Working on it. Don't take your gun out. Hmm? Trying to do stealth. Okay. We can't pick pockets yet. It's through here. Is this anything? Oversight prayer beads, slims. Maybe there's an item we've got to pick up somewhere. Oh, damn it! and we're out. Yeah, let's explore, because I don't know if I'm not just doing that all day. Speak to Gladys.
Try not to be distracted by the glare of the adverts. Lots of unsavory types about.
It's time for a
squads, blood running in the streets, all kinds of shit.
So it went about as well as everybody expected.
Yep, complete fucking fiasco.
We
move cargo 16 hours a day, and half of us take heavy equipment.
That's capitalism for ya.
Ooh, can we rent an upstairs room?
Oh god.
The board would like to remind spacers and other travelers that passage to Monarch is restricted for your protection.
I think no one's allowed to go to what, to Monarch.
Bless my heart.
There we go.
A stranger come knocking on a poor old woman's door. You here for a particular reason? Or did the neighbors tell you how good my sugar cookies are? Made without a single natural ingredient or an oven, just like store-bought.
Not a single natural ingredient or a... Jesus. Phineas sent me, he said you could sell me a nav key to Stellar Bay.
Those have been the height of illegality since Stellar Bay turned their noses up at the board. You and I could be thrown to the void just for discussing such a transaction. Lucky for us, Groundbreaker's a free port. We're outside of the board's control. For the time being, at least. Now, I only have the one nav key, and they're hard to come by these days. It won't be cheap. If you find yourself lacking in the bits, I might have an opportunity you'd be interested in.
Go on. Tell me about this opportunity. Oh, any chance of a discount since Phineas sent me?
Phineas? That old kook. He was quite the dancer back in his prime, did he tell you? Real light on his feet. Real light in the wallet, too. He still owes me a small fortune. Laws. Maybe I should charge you double.
Fine, tell me about your opportunity.
Well, I find I'm in need of a ship captain with a little moral flexibility. Might be this could help out the groundbreaker, as well as earn some bits. But if you've got qualms...
I ain't got no qualms. Let's see the details.
Do you know Edna over in engineering? Sweet as a pea, that one. On occasion, she'll pass along transmissions I might find interesting. She sent me a recording of a distress signal she'd scraped from the groundbreaker's comm array. Curious thing is, it came from an outpost called Roseway. And Auntie Cleo abandoned that place years ago.
Why was Roseway abandoned?
Can't say I know for sure. Maybe it never really was.
Sounds like someone poking into somewhere they shouldn't be got into a spot of trouble.
Comm centers don't operate themselves, Captain. Someone had to have sent that distress call manually.
Those corps are cleverer than all get out. Might have been a ruse to keep the rest of the board from sniffing around.
Say no more. I'm in.
You've got an ear for intrigue and a nose for bits. I like that. Here's a copy of the SOS recording, complete with the coordinates. If you should find a secret worth selling, might be I could find a buyer. Corporate bigwigs will pay top bit for inside information on their competitors. The more we got the corps fighting each other, the less time they got to meddle in our affairs.
Abandoned outpost, corporate secrets. Got it.
Don't forget to come find old Gladys when you're done.
What other jobs do you know about?
Might want to acquaint yourself with Junlei Tennyson, Groundbreaker's chief. She's been trying to get a handle on this heat problem we've got. You'll find her fretting in engineering. I'd say she's a sweet girl, but law for fen, someone call me a liar.
Thanks for your time.
Anytime, sweetheart. You know where to find me. Here, take a candy with you.
I like that she's a smuggler whose personality is like a sweet old granny. Alright, I think I'm probably going to call it here, you know. Just realised there's a lot of conversations and talking and stuff coming up. Not a lot of stuff happening. Which is fine, it's what the game is. But I feel like we've done... What do you reckon? Like, I think I'm just getting hungry and tired. And I think, like... Yeah, I'm going to call it here. I'm kind of tempted to keep pushing on, but I don't know how... I'm like losing my words and stuff. I need to take like a break. I think all that reading on the ship kind of wore me out. But that's good. We've had some progress so far today. We've sorted out the Edgewater problem. We've got... That's the best proper... The best proper ending for Edgewater. We've explored the ship. We've made some friends. We've got onto the Groundbreaker. And now I think we'll explore the Groundbreaker next week. And I think we started late as well. And I'm kind of like... I've had like a busy day today. This is like the first time I've sat down all day. Figuratively speaking. So I was playing D&D before, but it's like the first time I've like not been with people all day. Anyway, I'm just looking at what we've got to do next. So next week we'll talk to Udon Bedford, Janlay Tennyson. We'll explore the Groundbreaker and take a look at all this stuff and see what's here. In the meantime, you can find my social medias on Twitter at twitter.com/GalethaMatt. That's GALLAETHA_Matt with two T's. I don't use Twitter a great deal anymore. I'm kind of around every now and then. But I'm not like on it as much as I used to be. I am mainly on Blue Sky now. We can find me at GalethaMatt, which is all one word this time. That's GALLAETHAMATT. And then it's .bsky.social. If you're on Blue Sky, if you've got an invite code, then yeah, I'm on there. Follow me there. Check out my website, matthollandauthor.com, for short stories you can read for free. You can support my Patreon at patreon.com/galithamat, that's GALLATHA_Matt with two T's. Check out my books, Hair of the Dog, which is just a book series you can read on Amazon. It's well reviewed, people like it, check it out. That'll call it for today. I hope you had a good time. Sorry we didn't get as much done, but I say tired, and I don't know how effective I'll be at streaming from now on. So, yeah, take care, everybody. I'll see you all next time.